please proceed. Join in.
First of all, I'd like to thank Scott and Steph, and especially their parents, for such a beautiful wedding. Give them a round of applause, please. My name is Tyrone, and this is my wife, Tiffany. And we're doing a joint speech, but she has known them way longer than I have, so she'll be doing the bulk of it. Just focus your attention on her, I'll be over here.
Hi, Tiffany. I met Scott back in Chinese school when we were about 6 or 7 years old. However, we didn't really become close friends until middle school. And in middle school, we were actually paired up in a Chinese New Year dance together, some like really awkward dance. And then it was super embarrassing, and we both really, really hated it. I think there's a video out there somewhere.
No.
We weren't smartphones back then. So, Scott and I became better friends after a few years, and we became super close. Throughout the later half of high school and college after, Scott was always the person I went to, the person I talked to the most. He was my confidant. We talked about everything, and he saw me grow through my entire relationships and all of my relationships. I met Steph on a spring day. We were at our college fraternity revealing where Bigs and Littles are paired up. It must have been fate that we were paired up, even though I graduated and moved up to LA right after I picked her up. We saw each other almost every single weekend, and now 8 years later, we're still best friends. In the years I've known Steph, sorry, I'm shaking a lot. In the years I've known Steph, she's been my closest friend. She's the person I go to for everything and anything. She always knows. So Steph is my other half and my better half. She's always one step ahead of me, always more caring. She's a jelly to my peanut butter. We actually have matching sweaters that say that. So there isn't a day that goes by when we don't talk. Who would have thought that a big little pairing would turn into such a great friendship? So I want to tell you guys a little story. So several years before Steph and Scott started dating, I tried to set them up. I took Steph to my favorite sandwich restaurant and had her meet a few of my guy friends, hoping that she would like Scott. Unfortunately, neither of them showed any interest, but fast forward a few years later, and they actually fell in love in Vegas. So, thus began the most sickeningly loving relationship I've ever seen. I told them that almost already. I've never seen two people happier, and I do recall Steph saying one day, "I can't study so much because I love him."
Oh! Okay, so Steph really did say that. So I think I'm pretty accurate in saying that I've only known these two as they are now, which is as a couple. I didn't get to know Scott until later in life. I did meet Steph a couple times in college, but it was only in passing. I really doubt she even remembers. So when I really started to get to know them, they were already dating. And so to me, Steph and Scott, or Scoff as we affectionately refer to them as, have and always will be a singular thing. The thought of them living separate lives is too odd to think about. When I think about it, it baffles me that it took them this long to get married. Honestly, they've been acting like an old married couple for years now. Okay, Steph goes to sleep when most of us are finishing dinner, and Scott is always complaining about young people on social media. And then they even have a routine where Steph will nag or make Scott do something, and he'll throw a tantrum and be really mad. But we all know that deep down, he would do anything for her. I think I can speak for all of us here when I say, finally, you guys are married. And we couldn't be happier. So, if everyone can lift their glasses up. To sign up.
Yeah! All right, guys, we have one more speech. We want to bring ourselves out, and that is to hear from your bride and groom, Scott and Steph, the new Mr. and